Now we are almost ready to solve. Let's go under the Solution menu and select Solution Methods. For our scheme, we're going to select Coupled and leave everything else here as default. We're also going to select Pseudo-Transient and High-Order Term Relaxation. This will help our solution to converge. We're going to go into Monitors, and we're going to just take a look at our residuals. So hit Edit, and you can see here we're just going to leave our residuals. So hit OK, but we're also going to create some monitors. So hit Create and drag. So we're going to hit Print to Console and plot over our wall zones. And our force vector for the drag is 0.9986. And y is 0.0534. Hit OK. And we're also going to create one for lift. Same procedure. Print to console and plot over our wall zones. The only thing that's changing here is our force vector. So in the x, we're going to put negative 0.0534. And for the y, it's going to be 0.9986. Once you've done that, hit OK. And we're going to go into solution initialization. So hit standard initialization and compute from the inlet. And let's just make sure that our values are matching what we would expect and what we've entered and our boundary conditions. So our gauge pressure and looks good, and our temperature is also what we've entered. And just, you know, rough eyeball, we can see that our x and y velocity are matching what we would expect as well. So we can hit initialize. Let's go into the reference values. So the reference values aren't actually going to affect the solution of our problem, but they will affect the post-processing. So we're going to compute them from the inlet. And when we do that, we don't actually change the area or the length. So we're actually going to input our own area and the length of the reference values. We're going to enter for the area 1.076 feet squared, and the length scale is 1. Okay, finally, if we go into run calculation, since we selected pseudo-transient under our solution methods, we're going to see this extra pseudo-transient options. Leave everything as is there. Before we enter the number of iterations and calculate our solution, we're going to want to make sure that the data quantities that we want to look at are exported from Fluent into CFD Post. So click on Data File Quantities, and let's select the pressure coefficient and the Mach number to be exported from Fluent. Hit OK. Finally, under the number of iterations, enter 250. Once we've done that, we are ready to solve. So click Calculate.